Can someone bring Magic Matt a cup of coffee, please? Now then, I know you've spoken to some of our officers and they've taken down your statement, but if you don't mind, I'd like to hear from you in person. So please, tell me, Matt, how did you end up at the Godfather's mansion?
It were last Sunday. I was riding Marcus across the Middleham Dales. When these two leery lads pulled up, at first I thought they wanted to look at me mammoth, because he's a fucking mammoth. But the first lad was like, "Here, the Godfather wants to talk to you." And the other lad got out the car, and it was the Godfather, and he was all like, "Hello, Magic Man. I would like you to perform at my daughter's wedding next week." And I was like, "Sorry, lad, but I've got Lombos that day." And he was like, "Room Runner Rudy is a mate of mine. He has released you for the day."
Yes, we're all very aware of Room Runner Rudy's relationship with the Godfather. He declined the Godfather's offer, and as a result ended up with a horse's head in his bed.
That weren't a horse. That was a comic. Long-faced Lisa.
Shit. I'll have Homicide look into it. Please, Matt, continue.
Well, I didn't have much of a choice, did I? So I took the gig. The wedding were massive. Opulence overload. There were some big names there too. Salami Sandro.
Hey, who like a summer salami?
Oprah Winfrey. Pepperoni Pete were there.
Hey, I'm Pepperoni Pete.
And Brian Blessed. Even Maury Povich. There were two other performers. Italian Ian. Italian Ian is a very clever comedian who takes popular songs and changes words to Italian words, like pasta and stuff. He were a big hit with the crowd, playing songs like Hotel California, which he changed to
"The plenty of room at the Hotel Bafangula."
And Hakuna Matata, which was now
"Hakuna Lasagna, what a wonderful meal."
And crowd favourite, Vienna by Ultravox.
"The double is gone and the ravioli, there is nothing for me. There is nothing for me.
Italian Ian was destroying. I was getting nervous, so I went and sat in the green room, where I bumped into the surprise headliner, Kermit the Frog. "How are you, Matt?" "Oh, Kermit, what are you doing here?" "I'm the surprise headliner." "Oh, that's great, man. What's been happening?" "Too much, mate. If I'm honest, I'm pretty shattered. Godfather has me running round doing all sorts. As soon as I'm done here, I'm off on the plane to Miami for the opening of a shopping centre." "You must be buggered, Kermit." "Too fucking right I am. It's not easy being green, eh?" "Fuck off." Kermit had distracted me from my nerves. But it was now time for me to go and do my thing. I thought about doing a bit where I fart the names of all the people on the Middleham sex offenders list, but most of them were present. So I opted to do some crowd work. It were brilliant. They were loving it. I were killing more than one of the Godfather's henchmen during a hostile takeover of a racket of sorts. The Godfather loved it. His daughter loved it. The son, who just got back from war, he loved it.
Hoo-ah!
I didn't want to tire them out for the main act, though, so I decided to cut it short. and I said to them, "Are you ready for me to bring on your surprise headliner?" The place went silent. The Godfather shouted out from his seat, "You are the headliner." He looked so confused. "No, I'm not. What about Kermit the Frog?" Just as the words left me lips, Kermit burst out from behind a bush with a machine gun and shouted, "Hey, Godfather, how do you like these cannolis?" And he proceeded to open fire. Don Marcus and got the fuck out of there just as Kermit turned his gun on the Don.
Thank you, Magic Matt. Your account of events has been most useful. Sadly, though, we are no closer to working out how Kermit is connected to the Godfather.
Maybe it's a rainbow connection.
Very good.